it's the Grease Man from the city where, well, you know, where you live. Hey, you probably got to set your alarm clock, put the cat out. Where I live, this is what I do every night before I go to sleep. Lock and load, buddy. Lock and load. Yeah, there's my honey and me cuddling, and there's that 870 and flying between us. The other night I woke up, I was sucking the barrel. I was like, what does that mean? Is there some sort of latency going on? I hope not. You know, Grease Minnelli, 800-544-9294 is the number. All right, I got to take a little break here. I'll come back with more action ahead. Yeah, the Grease still here, still rocking, still bap, bip, bap, punching away. Taking your phone calls, too, at 800-544-9294. Hang on tight for more of the Grease Man Show.
Faithful New Yorkers, you have waited so patiently for this weekend, a weekend where a message will descend over Central Park and beyond, a message of peace, a message of hope, a message of butt-kicking, door-slamming, hand-down classic rock and roll!
Since the Pope's in town, we at 92.3 K-Rock thought we'd serenade him with the music of rock and roll's guitar gods. Hendrix, Page, Beck, Clapton. We're playing them all this weekend. Turn us on and leave us on for the Guitar Gods Weekend. From New York's only classic rock station, 92.3 K-Rock. We're 92.3 K-Rock, the classic rock station. And we continue our tradition of playing the best rock and roll ever made.
Just let me hear some of that rock and roll music.
Back
more than ever, you can count on us. We're New York's only classic rock station, 92.3 K-Rock.
Let the day be good, never let it end. Let the good times roll, let me be your friend. Let the mountain come to you, Coors Light. Tap the Rockies, let the sun shine on your face. Let the fun begin.
Coors Light, the silver bullet. It's shipped cold to preserve the clean taste of the Rockies. When you want a beer this fresh and true, let the mountain come to you. Coors Light.
Never let it end. Coors Light. Tap the Rockies.
Tap the Rockies with Coors Light. Thank you, New York and New Jersey, for making Coors Light your number one light beer.
Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado.
And you can tell everybody this is your song.
Rockin' Man, burning out the shoes out here song.
For over 20 years, you've heard it.
And it seems to me.
In one gold record after another, you've loved it.
Like a candle in the wind.
Now, piece of gold thinks it's time you saw him. Elton John is here in concert, and we reserve a number of seats for Visa Gold card holders. Select seats, because missing Elton John in concert is like missing a piece of music history. All you have to do is call, because nothing beats the power of gold. Visa Gold presents Elton John's 1995 North America Tour. It's everywhere you want to be. Limit 4 tickets per card holder.
For seats reserved exclusively for Visa Gold card holders, call 212-307-4004 to see Elton John live in concert at the Garden October 12th, 13th, 14th, 17th, 19th, and 20th.
Coach, can you tell us why you decided to go for two?
Well, once I looked up at the board, my decision was pretty easy.
The board?
Yeah, the menu board at McDonald's. That's when I knew I had to go for two.
This is the two-for-two buck conversion at McDonald's. You can get two sausage McMuffin with egg sandwiches for $2, or two quarter pounder with cheese sandwiches also for $2 when you buy a large fries.
Would you do it again if you had the chance, Coach?
Yeah, I'm going to do it again tomorrow.
Prices and participation may vary. Offer good for a limited time.
McDonald's presents another Breakfast with the Newlyweds.
Morning, honey. Sorry I didn't have time to cook breakfast.
That's okay. I'll stop at McDonald's.
Oh, no need. mean? I heated up those black and Cajun waffles.
Oh, too bad. At McDonald's, hearty appetites can supersize any breakfast extra value meal for just 39 cents and get extra hash browns and a large coffee instead of a small. Another everyday breakfast value you'll find at McDonald's. But you got to get there first.
Honey, you do so much. Tomorrow, I'll take care of breakfast.
Have you had your break today?
Prices and participation may vary.
Ladies, gentlemen, as you know, I, Mr. Num Num, have been under increasing pressure to turn a profit lately. So without further ado, I proudly present our newest creation, Mr. Num Num Super Moist Cookies, the first cookies you can eat all by themselves.
Can we get a picture of you eating one?
Certainly you can. Yes, I believe that. Mr. Num Num's Super Moist.
Could somebody give
them
milk?
No milk. I don't need milk for Super Moist Cookies.
Got milk. Brought to you by America's Dairy Farmers.
It's just like a dream you can hold in your hands. Poor stole your heart once, it'll steal it again.
Ford introduces the all-new Taurus.
It's a dream within reach, and it's you at your best.
Taurus, making the dream come true for you.
Listening to The Greaseman Show on the classic rock station 92.3 K-Rock.
Pardon me for my heavy metal thunder. I just can't control myself. Hey, I tell you what, there's some kind of wacky happen to Oscar Greaseman, Ellie. One of his friends passed away. And, you know, Daddy is, you know, you can say all these things about him, that he's a no-gooder and all of that. But when it comes to doing the right thing, he always does the right thing. And when he heard that his friend, Howie Pumpson, died, he wanted to make sure he'd go to the services. So he put on his good suit. Mama said, what are you doing in your good suit in the middle of the week? Daddy said, well, Howie Pumpson died. I want to go by. He's being laid out 4 o'clock this afternoon. I'll be home in time for dinner. The daddy, as usual, gets the address wrong. And he goes into this place. Turns out to be a house of ill repute. He thinks he's at Howie Pumpson's place. He goes through, sees a bunch of guys sitting around waiting. And he figures, I'm in the right spot, right? They're all waiting to view. Well, he's sitting there smoking a Camel when all of a sudden a naked dame comes out of a room. Takes him upstairs and... Daddy's flabbergasted, but he's going along with it. She rides him every which way but sudden. Tears him up. Daddy starts getting into it. Finally, he leans back. Falls over and says, I don't know about you Pumpsons, but this is a hell of a funeral. The woman's confused. Funeral? Yeah, this ain't no funeral. This is a house of ill repute. And Daddy said, oh, man, thank God. I thought that rotten smell was from the corpse.
Can we have a party here tonight?
It's the Greaseman Show.
All right, crank up that blower. 800-544-9294 is my number. It's the Grease. Along with the Pretenders. Here's the Greaseman. Keep it loud. The only way to do it, man. 800-544-9294. If you're going to go in, you might as well go in do dad deep, I say. Here's Led Zepp.
If the days are by you, I will tell you.
The docket. Let me tell you, you got a short break here, then we're going to come back and lose control. Johnny Avocado here with what you need. 800-544-9294 if you'd like to jump on this puppy. Stand by for more of the Greaseman Show.
Music and more.
your stories. It's the Greaseman Show on New York's only classic rock station, 92.3 K-Rock.
I'll free up a couple of lines, and that way you'll be able to get through at 800-544-9294. Hi.
Hi, Grease.
Yes, sir.
My name is Fidel.
Fidel.
And I was wondering if, I'm an architect here in New York City, and I work a lot of hours.
Yes, Fidel.
I was wondering if you had any prior architectural experience.
Well, I wouldn't call myself an architect. Does being a contractor help?
Oh, hey, it's close enough.
Does being a cow, does putting up houses in subdivision after subdivision, does that help?
Oh, yeah.
When I'm not designing them, but I'm putting them up like a cookie cutter. The same plans, day in, day out, tract housing, boom, boom, boom. Huh?
Well, believe me, I'm not designing them either, but I do a heck of a lot of drafting out here.
All right, well, I understand that, buddy. I understand it completely. I had to get out of that business. Sure, it was lucrative for a while then. The real estate glut of the 80s. We were selling them as fast as we could put them up. But you know what bugged me? Not the actual work. I like the work of building a house. Sometimes people would buy one, and then they'd come out, they'd look at us with the bulldozers digging the hole. And then they'd look at us doing everything. I mean, I'd be trying to get something done. The place would be going nuts. There'd be guys, you know, typical job site. Pounding and building. And then a car would pull up and I'd say, oh my God, it's the owners. And they'd get out in the middle of all our work. And they'd be walking around saying, are you sure you want to use those kind of gauge sockets? And they told me you were going to use 495D fiberglass for insulation. This is not 495D. Believe me, it's as good as 495D. They'd be walking around checking. Hey, this ain't level. Look at the guy having a level with him. He'd lay it on a 2x4 and say, look at a bubble. I'd be like, oh, and it's level. He said, no, the bubble's out of a little square there. And I'm like, Well, I had this one guy drive me so completely nuts. Showing up every day. There I am. I'd be looking through the toolbox trying to figure out a wrench big enough to brain him with it. He got me to the point where I couldn't take it anymore. The thought of him gave me indigestion. I showed up on a Saturday night. All my workers were gone. I knew this guy wouldn't be around. I brought with me all the C4 plastic explosive I'd smuggled out of Vietnam. I put it in the walls. Every room in the place. Put a long life battery in it, radio receivers, and priming caps. And then, all by myself, started laying on the drywall so you couldn't see it. I worked all through the night, then halfway through Sunday. Monday, I showed up. No sleep, but I felt great. All my workers were like, hey, put the drywall in here. Man, oh, we got to slap some paint. I said, that's right.
All you got to do is slap some paint on.
We finished the house. I called the owner. I said, it's ready. He said, it's ready? I said, yeah, it's ready. I watched as they moved in. They had their little ceremony. Their stinking friends over. I didn't do anything right away. 1 year went by. 2 years went by. 3 years went by. Four, and then five. Finally, the time was right.
I pulled up. Just about sunset. In my lap, I had the radio transmitter. I could see the guy that made my life miserable, sitting there reading his paper,
Slowly, my car edged forward. I could see his wife in the kitchen. The woman that was never satisfied with the color of the paint. I saw the children in their stinking bedroom. The children that sicked their dog at me. The moment I waited for it had come.
I hit the detonator!
It burned. I could hear the distant wail of sirens as I stepped out of my car and walked through the flames. The woman lifeless. The kids. Paste. The living room, the guy was still there on one elbow. I walked over to him. I said, "Hey, remember me?" I see he wasn't long for it, so I picked him up and I carried him to the blast crater in the middle of the living room and I said, "Here you go, buddy. Here's that sunken living room you're always bitching to me about."
The Greaseman Show.
Dino Grease Vanelli, keeping them coming. I tell you what, when it comes to stacking them up,
I got a handle on it.
You too. The Grease and you too. Let me grab a quick call here. Hi.
While the Pope is merely a mile from where I sit here in my home in Newark, and while I've had the opportunity to attend this solemn service, I have not.
Well, now you don't have to go see the Pope.
But I'm listening to you instead.
Well, now wait a minute now. What we're doing here is God's work. It's laughter, it's fellowship, it's guidance, it's togetherness.
I listen to Grease. I tape Grease. I sing Grease songs.
All right, well, I'll bless you.
While you're here. Absolve me.
If you could please get down on one knee. Let me take out my go-getter. Let me take out my go-getter here. All right, there. Here you go. My son, my joy, my life. There you go.
I am cleansed.
Would have been easier for you to see the Pope. With him, all you got to do is kiss his ring. Look at this.
His Highness of
A short break and then more action ahead. Linger longer because there's more of the Greaseman Show.
And now, great moments in telephone history from 92.3 K-Rock. 1877, Alexander Graham Bell inadvertently connects two wires together.
Watson, come here quickly. I need you.
1922, the first intercontinental trunk line is completed, linking two continents together.
So it's agreed. You'll let us have those croissant things and that French roast coffee in our cafes.
And you will lease us the Jerry Lewis movies for the cinema.
1995, Fred from Hackensack arranges to meet Sue from Bayside via the K-Rock connection, thus linking together two really nice people.
Cool. I'll meet you from the theater at 8.
Liven up your own history with the K-Rock connection. It's easy, it's fun, and membership is free. So is the toll-free number, 1-800-321-WXRK. That's 1-800-321-WXRK. The K-Rock connection, bringing people together. From the Classic Rock Station, 92.3 K-Rock.
It's the Greaseman Show on the Classic Rock Station, 92.3 K-Rock.
Now, with more music and more stories, you're listening to the Greaseman Show on New York.
You better plan the next. We can look at it and say, well, I like that. That worked. That was okay. No, we could do this a little bit better. So if you were there in Philly, if you were there in D.C., if you were there when I did New York, and we tripped the light fantastic in Atlanta, and you got some video on that, I'd like to see it. So you can just call me. I'm answering the phone every day. Anytime after 5 p.m. all the way till 10 at 800-544-9294 or email me about it, greaseshow@aol.com, and we can do a swap. And I'll put together my little collage, and Lord knows what'll happen. Hi, it's the Greaseman Show.
Hey.
Hey.
The trainer wanted to speak to you.
Hey, well, no, I want your estimation of the O.J. situation.
Mine?
Yeah, what do you think about O.J. Simpson? Guilty or innocent?
Let me see. I'd say innocent.
Why would you say that?
Because you know how you men are when y'all get to fighting?
Yes.
Something get broke.
What makes him innocent then if there's two dead people? You just said that when we get to fight and something get broke.
Uh-huh.
Well, but so why does that make him innocent?
Something.
Huh? Why does that make him innocent?
That's how y'all fight, because men fight dirty.
Yeah, but of the charge of the murdering of two individuals on Bundy, why would, because we fight when we get licked up, why would that make him innocent?
Y'all get licked up.
Yeah, but why is he innocent? Tell me why he's innocent. This is what America wants to know. We want to get in your head. Talk to us. Help us, the lowly honky, understand your thinking. Why is he innocent? Huh?
I just said because y'all always get something broken. Y'all fighting.
But that's men in general, you're saying. Uh-huh. But why is this? I want to find out why this OJ is innocent. Tell me why he's innocent. I mean, we heard everything the jury heard, so I feel like a juror. Why would you, as a juror, say he's innocent?
Because they couldn't find no evidence. They couldn't prove it.
They couldn't prove it? Hell, you wouldn't know DNA from the PTA, would you? For God's sakes. Evidence? They had more evidence in the history of any murder trial in the history of the world. They had more evidence. And you tell me they couldn't find any evidence? You gloat, huh? Laugh in our faces, why don't you? Oh, I was tempted to wait on the roof of the courthouse. But not with a sniper rifle. Oh, no. With my hydraulics locked in my fist. And when that jury came walking out, I was tempted. Just be waiting. And then just... There you go. Hey, that's from all of us.
Why you have to waste it? Why couldn't you... How come you couldn't use it on me?
Oh, well, oh, God. But I wouldn't give... I'm trying to settle down. I just... Yeah, so you're telling me... I'm just trying to come to grips with it.
Huh?
I'm trying to come to grips with that verdict. Damn it, it's about time somebody said something. We as a people are hurting. There's all these celebrations and parties going on. Hootenannies and whistles being blown. And yet, there's a great stillness among the masses. And I'm just wondering how you could say... With the massive DNA, the bloody socks, the cars splattered with blood, the history of battery, the constant haranguing, bordering on stalking behavior, and you say they had no evidence. I'm nonplussed. Stupefied, in other words. You laugh, don't you? You laugh when they announce that verdict, didn't you? Were you watching it?
Like that.
Were you watching when the verdict was read? Were you watching when it was read?
Uh-huh.
And did you throw back your head and hoot?
I was kind of at the doctor with Katrina, so I couldn't do all that.
I understand. But I bet you when he had his hand in there buried deep and you started chuckling, you nearly choked him off at the wrist, didn't you? All right there, sweetheart. No hard feelings, huh? That's done. It's over here. Let me give you a big hug. Let me hold you. Come on. Come on. Put your arm around me. Yeah, let me give you a squeeze, too. I didn't know all the politicians are saying, it's time to heal. Yeah. That's why I can't check the topicality. Too many inconsistencies drive me nuts. Should have seen me on my balcony. I overlooked downtown L.A., and I was out there yelling, are you serious? Are you serious? Honey said, come on. Inside, she grabbed me by my bathrobe. My doodads were swinging free. Oh, man. That's why sometimes I don't check topicality. It's much easier just to tell stories. And we can all laugh together. We're not divided by some wedge. A joke's a joke. A laugh's a laugh. Lately, I've been studying the history of Tarzan. Now, that I find fascinating. To think that a man... to be raised in the jungle. And only find his first human contact when he met Jane. I've been at the library late nights, poring through musty tacits. One interesting story is Tarzan and Jane were swinging vine to vine. And as they were swinging, Jane was, well, undoing his loincloth. And as they were swinging, she was kind of... You know, there's Tarzan going... Well, he's getting hot, and she's getting a little hot. So as they're going along through the jungle like that, she says, Tarzan, see that patch of grass down there? Why don't we lower ourselves and monkey around a little bit?
He looked at her, he said, Jane, please don't refer to our love life as monkeying around. It brings back embarrassing memories.
Your baby doc of rock.
Hey. What's up, Doc?
You're listening to the Greaseman Show.
Yeah, I say that's the best way to do it, right? We just not think about OJ's pay-per-view and the OJ dolls and all that stuff. A new TV show they're contemplating, At Home with OJ. Let's just rock a little bit. What do you say? 800-544-9294. It's Johnny Avocado.
You always live your life.
All right, stand by. It's a great spot. Ready for another lucidity check. So hang on tight. Blow is jumping. You know what people are talking about. What the heck? 800-544-9294 is the number to spill your guts. Stand by. There's more of the Greaseman Show.
Time now for Fun with Your Phone from 92.3 K-Rock. Fun with Your Phone number one, ordering food.
So that's 10 6-inch cheese pizzas.
No, man. 6 10-inch pizzas, dude.
Fun with Your Phone number two, ordering people around.
If you don't get Marcellus the suitcase by Monday, you can kiss your sister Shirley goodbye.
Fun with Your Phone number three, actually getting your love life in order with the K-Rock Connection.
So I'll see you by the arch at 4:30 on Saturday.
Great, Sam. Looking forward to it.
The K-Rock Connection is more than just a fun thing to do. It's a real way to meet somebody really cool. It's easy, it's fun, and membership is free. So is the toll-free number, 1-800-321-WXRK. That's 1-800-321-WXRK. The K-Rock Connection, bringing people together. From the classic rock station, 92.3 K-Rock.
From the beginning, they looked to you for help.
Daddy, could you help me tie my shoe? Mom, will you help me find my hamster? Will you help me reach the top shelf?
And because you're a parent, they trust you to know exactly what to do.
Will you help make my bike go faster? Can you help check my spelling?
It's not always easy, but encouraging your kids to come to you now will make it easier for them to come to you later.
Brad says I'm not cool unless I go. What should I do?
Especially when they encounter more serious situations, such as underage drinking. So to help you help them, Anheuser-Busch offers Family Talk About Drinking, a video and free series of guidebooks with professional advice to enable you to work together towards solutions.
If everyone else is doing it, how do I say no?
Help us stop underage drinking before it starts. Get your Family Talk kit today by calling 1-800-359-TALK. That's 1-800-359-TALK. A message from Anheuser-Busch.
Silver Bullet. It's shipped cold to preserve the clean taste of the Rockies. When you want a beer this fresh and true, let the mountain come to you. Coors Light.
Get ready. Gonna make it mine. It's a mountain of a good time. Coors Light. Tap the Rockies. And let the mountain come to you. Coors Light. Tap the Rockies.
Tap the Rockies with Coors Light. Thank you, New York and New Jersey, for making Coors Light your number one light beer.
Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado.
My store made a change just for me.
Emporium, food Emporium.
My store has the best. service, the very best variety just for me.
The very best continues with a soda Tropicana pure premium orange or grapefruit juice, 64-ounce container, just $2.29 with coupon or bonus savings card. And for Italian week, Monticelli balsamic vinegar from Italy, 16-ounce bottle, just $2.49 with bonus savings card. Plus assorted contadina white or green pasta cuts, 9-ounce package, just $1.99, just for you.
The White Castle Crave. Man, what is it about those one-of-a-kind steam-grilled burgers that makes people go so gaga? Hey, man, let's go to the mailbag and find out. Okay, Jose Marrero of Queens writes,
the taste. I love the taste.
Gracias, Jose. Hey, our next letter comes to us from Kimberly Ring of Newark. She writes,
why, the mere thought of those yummy burgers makes me want to...
Okay, Kimberly, call me at home. Hey, this next little ditty comes to us from Donneth Barr of Long Island. Positively yummy and so affordable. Go figure. Leonard, bring me a beverage! Join the fun. Tell us why you crave. Call 1-800-THE-CRAVE. Just for calling, we're going to send you a limited edition What You Crave sticker. It's even got a way tasty coupon on the back for big discounts on your cravage, man. Limited time offer while supplies last. All right, and finally, Jack Crafasi of Brooklyn writes, I don't know why. All right, they're there. I love them. I eat them. Boom. Done.
White Castle, what you crave.
More music and more stories. It's the Greaseman Show on New York's only classic rock station, 92.3 K-Rock.
Numbers now, I hope. Fax number is 213-850-0986.
The phone number is 800-544-9294.
Hi. Well, I have a question for you.
All right, go ahead.
When Philip Van Adder and Mark Furman showed up at the scene, what do you think that they thought? I mean, did they think that they were going to just rush right on over to OJ's house and catch themselves a killer?
You know, I think they did. I think that was a tactical mistake on the trial to admit that they didn't think O.J. was a suspect and they were just going over to...
That's for one of it. And the other thing is that the jury must have believed that Mark Furman planted everything.
They must have.
As they kept saying, if you cannot believe the authorities, any aspect of what the... If you can't trust the police... Enforcement.
So you thought O.J. was innocent and...
I didn't say that. I'm just telling you that's the reason why. Perspective. What?
That's the reason why. That outrageous goings-on from Mark Furman and the sidestepping from Van Etten. We just went by to notify the family. I mean, they should have said, who else got in the bed? He's been beating the hell out of her for 10 years. We find her dead. Of course we're going to look for O.J. He's an immediate son. He's an immediate suspect. That's what they should have said. But instead, he was like, oh, no, we just went by there. You know, dip a glove. Why do they think he went by there? To offer him the starring role in a new movie, Edward Scissorhands Part 2, for God's sakes. They should have been honest. Instead, now look at us. Here's another fine mess you've gotten us into. I don't even want to think about it. Let's play the quiz. But you're welcome to spill your guts. Yeah, that's all right. I mean, we do a lot of stories, but, you know, a little topicality is always in order, I suppose. Let me find someone pick that random from the blower. Hi there, would you like to play the quiz?
I'd like to play the quiz.
Your first name and what do you do?
My name is Rob, and I work for a daytime talk show.
Oh, do you?
Yeah.
Can you tell us which one it is, Rob?
I roll tape for Ricky Lake.
I'll be darned. So when you're in there and it's like, roll tape! You're the guy that hits play and record.
I do that.
Very nice. Is she a nice woman?
Oh, she's very nice. She just had a birthday.
Oh, yeah. She's a young thing, isn't she?
She's only 27.
I tell you what, very speckable.
And she's very sharp, too.
Yeah, she seems like. Well, all right. Sounds good. I'll think of that every time I see that pop up. I'll think, hey, I know the guy that hits play and record on the Ricky Lake Show, and it's you. Pretty sweet. All right. Let's see what we got here. Look at this. It's the little papal beanie cap. Just like the one His Holiness wears.
Have you ever seen him? You know that hat he wears all the time?
No, what am I going to do with that?
Well, no, it's like a cross between a yarmulke and one of those things with the propeller on. But they broke off the propeller, so it's kind of halfway between there.
All right.
It's the papal beanie cap. I mean, you can wear it every now and then. You know, you see the Pope, you say, hey, look, we go to the same haberdasher. The hat look familiar? Okay. Anyway, I'm sure it'll come in handy for something. What's the difference between a man and a firefly? Man, when a firefly spies a welcome face, his tail lights up. When a man spots some willing tail, his face lights up. No, he didn't know it. Did you hear him blow it? Yes, he is a wacky guy. Oh, he didn't even try it because he knew I wouldn't buy it. Yes, he is a wacky guy. I'm sorry. Bite in the bag, I've got to take the little papal beanie cap and put it back in the hopper. But you gave it a good shot, so thank you so much for playing the quiz. I salute you for being a part of the ring thing, dude.
Thank you.
You bet. Thank you. Say hi to Ricky.
Okay, be good.
You too. Bye-bye. It's Dino Grease with Ellie. We're having some Genesis. Hit it. You never Look at me. It's Nino Grease with Ellie. Eyes blazing, heart pumping. Steve Miller time.
Keep on rocking me, baby. Keep on rocking me, rocking me, rocking
with your heart and heart.
Keep on rocking me, baby.
All right, man, I got a lot of palooza stuff lined up for you. Oh, Nelly. You came along at a good time. 800-544-9294 is the number. I'll be back in a second with more of the Greaseman Show.
We're 92.3 K-Rock, New York's only classic rock station. And we play the best rock and roll ever made, both yesterday and today. And you'll hear the latest from Neil Young, Van Morrison,
there'll be days like this,
Pink Floyd, with more great new releases to come, because it doesn't have to be old to be a classic on the classic rock station, 92.3 K-Rock.
You got the Grease on the classic rock station, 92.3 K-Rock.
It's the Greaseman Show on 92.3 K-Rock, WXRK,
New York.
Howard Stern all morning, classic rock and roll all day. More music and more stories. It's the Greaseman Show on New York's only classic rock station, 92.3 K-Rock.
About Nicole,
indeed.
Oh, I don't want to hear about Johnny Cochran. Well, all right, already with that. Enough. We can't run from it. Let's go to the blower. 800-544-9294. Hi, it's Grace.
Hi, Grace.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh man, I need some advice.
All right, go ahead.
Well, if you were married for 18 years, and I don't think you have been, but you had an affair with someone.
Yes.
And you got your wife involved with the person that you had the affair with?
Yes.
How would you feel? I mean, how would she feel?
How has she gotten you involved? He had an affair after 18 years of marriage with you, and then he brought this woman home for you to have a three-way.
Basically.
And did you have said three-way?
Yes.
And how was it?
Wonderful.
Well, it sounds like now he's got the best of both worlds. He's still got you. He can bring her in. And then you, it's the spark your marriage needed. So what's the problem?
What if I love her more than him?
Well, that can happen. And those kind of things over the years, I have found that the women tend to fall in love.
Yeah, we do.
So, but you don't have to dump him.
Well, no. I've had to dump her.
Why'd you have to dump her?
Because it was the only way to make it work.
You couldn't just have her come over every now and then?
No.
Why not?
Well, I mean, see,
your husband was the one that had the affair. He's the one that violated the marital covenant. You'd be quite within your rights of saying, honey, when's Zelda coming back over again? I had a nice time last Friday. I think we should make it a Wednesday and Friday thing. You, me, and Zelda.
What if I wanted to leave Bobo for Zelda?
That's not right. A good thing. You got kids, right?
Yeah.
And you're all entwined. You got a house. Your names are on all the accounts and all that crap, right?
Mm-hmm.
No, so that's wrong to do that. Because the damn thing is, when you're with Zelda 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, she'll get old, too.
Yeah, but Zelda never lied to me.
Yeah, give her time. So stick with the slug you got and bring Zelda in every Wednesday and Friday and be happy that you have a little fire back in your life.
Okay, Greece, I love you.
Love you too.
Bye.
Bye-bye. I mean, you know, you can't just torture a whole 18-year relationship with houses and children just because you think you're in love. In the long run, love is so fleeting. It's the partnership that endures. It lasts. And it just gets more complicated now. Hell, when I was single, you could walk into a bar and know who the players are. I'm always getting calls from people that say, Grease, I picked up this person and I'm, you know, I got a snarling and we were kissing and hugging. It turned out to be a girl. I mean, my God, it looks so real. And well, now with the unisex clothing, it can be difficult to tell people apart. So if I were in the dating game now and I walked into a bar at midnight and I wanted to figure out who's the guys, who's the gals, I'd walk into the middle of the room and scream, I smell poontang, and see which one snapped their legs shut.
Move to the music.
I mean, you gotta figure out ways to keep you from getting brutalized. Thorough good.
I walk 47 miles of barbed wire.
Here's Grace, stacking him up and stacking him deep. 800-544-9294 if you'd like it, a piece of the pie. Here's Billy Joel.
Well, you went uptown riding in your limousine with your fire.